POE Clock software allows you to effectively manage your synchronized clocks. POE Clocks provide accurate time that automatically adjusts for daylight savings time. Please, let's take a look at the software. On this screen, you can see that when you open the software, it's going to display all the clocks that are on your clock system. This would be both analog and digital, and will also include POE clocks and Wi-Fi clocks if you also have Wi-Fi clocks in your facility. First, you have the status. The status is, where is the clock? Is it online or is it offline? Or is it currently connecting, getting a time update as line one indicates with this analog Wi-Fi clock? Next is the clock type. Is it analog or digital? The next is the name of the clock. You can name the clock anything that makes sense for your organization. Next is the MAC address. The reason we provide this is some organizations, as part of their security for their network, do MAC address filtering. This way you have a complete list of the MAC addresses and you can provide them to IT to make sure that they are authorized to be on the network. Next is the IP address. This is valuable if you want to go into the individual clock, and I'll show you how we can do that in a second. Next is the time zone. Is the time zone the clock is located in? And follow that up with the last time it got an update. When's the last time the clock got an update? As you can see on the clock that's currently offline, it got an update yesterday. So something happened from today versus yesterday. Now I would like to highlight some of the functions that are used on the left side of the navigation bar, one being countdown, the other one being light level. Countdown, you can program any of the digital clocks to perform a countdown at a specific time. For example, in a high school where you want clocks at when there's a class change and you want the clock to display, the clocks in the hallway, to display how much time is left before the next class begins, you can schedule that. Then those hallway clocks will be displaying accurate time. And then when there's a class change, they will go into a countdown mode so that teachers and students know how much time they have left to get to the next class. The next one is the light level. This is beneficial, certainly in this age where we're trying to conserve energy. You can schedule all your digital clocks to go to be dimmed so that they're using less energy at non-operational times. Now I'd like to come back to the IP address that is listed for all our clocks on the software. When you select a clock, we're going to select third clock here. It's in building 7, hallway C. We'll just click on the IP address. And once we click on that IP address, it's going to take us right to the clock's webpage. We'll put the password in to have access to it. That'll take us right to the home page. Here we have the time and the date and if it's set up for daylight savings time, and then of course the firmware version of the clock. Next is the clock settings. On this page we can give the clock a name if we so desire. In this case it's building 7, hallway C. So if the clock appears to go offline, we can send a maintenance person to building 7, hallway C to check on that clock. It has a clock number, and also you can set up how often do you want it to check in and get a time update. It has the time zone, and if there's offset minutes, which are applicable to some countries throughout the world. Next is display settings. This is certainly applicable to the digital clocks. Do you want the time displayed in a 12-hour or a 24-hour display? Do you want the date format, month, day, year, or day, month, year? You can also have the digital clocks alternate between date and time, and then you would be able to indicate how long you want the time display to be on before it switches to the date display and how long you want the date display to be on. Also, you can see we could change the brightness of the display right here, and we could set a brightness schedule up so that maybe during the for this particular clock at a certain time it would go into a low brightness and saving energy. Then, depending on where you're located, you could set up daylight savings time, or if you were in the UK, British summertime, and you'll put the start date and the end date for that time adjustment. Next is the network settings. Typically, they're always self-populated. Probably the only adjustment that needs here, if your IT department wants to provide a static IP address for the clocks, where it says DHCP, that means the IP address is automatically provided by the network, they can switch that to off and then specify the IP address they want that clock to have. Next is network servers. Any clock system must have an accurate and reliable time source. We have 9 servers in here, so it's going to pull time via the internet from these trusted time sites, and therefore the whole clock system will have accurate, reliable, synchronized time. If you have an internal, if your IT department has an internal local time server, you can put that on and then put the IP address of that time server right in here. That is the POE clock software. If we could provide you a quote, or if you need more information, please give us a call or go to www.innovationwireless.com.